we know these two. They are your hosts of the 131st Rose Parade. Mark Steines, Leeza Gibbons joining us, telling us all about prepping for the big day. I'd imagine it's going to be pretty busy.
It is going to be a busy day for all of us, I think.
It's such a lovely day, such a beautiful tradition. We're so proud to be part of your family and to give you the very best coverage. And we've been out in the field bringing you the stories that make it special.
Can we first share with our family gifting? We have to come.
Gifting.
We have gifting.
Are these the official?
These are the official pins.
These are the KTLA pins.
Oh, wow.
Can you see? These are the KTLA pins.
Here you go, Kai.
Which we are wearing.
Oh, there's one more coming down. Jessica.
So that's the way you know that you're official.
Yes.
Mark is also wearing the
I am sporting
theme.
I have this one over here. This is the parade one. Given to me by the president.
Laura Farber, with our meeting with her,
which we'll tell you about in a second. But yes, it's a wonderful theme this year, by the way, the power of hope. And as I continue to take in more of this and ingest more of it, I just want everybody on New Year's Day morning to leave, you know, enjoy it, but take that message with them throughout the year, because the power of hope is so important. It never quits.
And it's like Laura, as he said, we really loved meeting with Laura. Everybody at the Rose Parade has passion and purpose, and she just brings with it as the third female, first Latina. And she brings with it this focus of, let's look at how this parade offers scholarships and opportunity and community
the
building.
The power of hope is right here.
And there's our Grand Marshals.
So is that the basis behind the theme?
Yes.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, she, just going through this, every float, everybody that's there talks about, this is what we bring to this. Even the you know, there's some first times, like the Mayflower float that's there, talking about, can you imagine the hope the people who boarded that Mayflower and took that initial voyage, the hope that they must have carried with them? And you know, this is the very first time in 131 years that hope, the word hope, has ever been in the title.
We were shocked to hear that. I find that hard to believe, right?
Yeah.
So
let's talk for a moment about the preparation going into this, because I know, Leeza, you've been, you went to the War Horses, or no, I'm sorry, you went with the Arabian Horse Association.
Amazing.
Okay, so, tell us about that.
So these horses are so beautiful. They're so intelligent. You can see eternity in their eyes. And this young man, Ryan Melendez, at 17 years old, he was diagnosed with a pretty aggressive form of leukemia. Now, while he's literally at death's door, he comes up with this program, you guys, to match horses with other kids that have cancer. And in that, which is really smart, because the horses come, the people that donate the horses also provide money but to research for pediatric cancer. But what they provide more than that is a chance for that kid to have this relationship with this intelligent, inquisitive animal, where the kid feels powerful, and it's not about the sickness for one day. Their family gets to be in this environment where that kid has this bonding. You know, that equine therapy is that X factor that has been so meaningful for so many. So I'm so impressed with him. I had a great day. Oh, and I brought you all Warrior Horses bracelets, compliments of the Warrior Kids Warrior Horses program.
Thank you.
By the way, there's miniature therapy horses, like, once again in the parade, going back to your equine therapy.
You guys have brought so much swag. I want one of those turtlenecks.
Is it in vogue or out of vogue? I wanted to go last year with it, but I couldn't.
Mark, you had your own experience with the horsewomen of Temecula.
Mine took much more restraint on my behalf, because I went to Temecula Valley, which is home for the horsewomen of wine country there.
Look how beautiful.
Kathleen Bade from our sister station from Fox 5 in San Diego joined me. She constrained me in wine country. Beautiful, beautiful area. This is their first appearance in the parade, the horsewomen, and they are so, so excited. But we had a chance to tour many of the vineyards there. There's 48 of them, and Temecula Valley has been named one of the top destinations by Wine Enthusiast magazine in the country, or in the world, actually, which is in our backyard. And a lot of people don't realize that. But it's gorgeous there, and they're all about horses, well-being of horses. They actually, in that community, have horse crosswalks set up the same way that's designed specifically for horses to go through. It is really an amazing community that's come together, and it's all women. It's all women. There's mothers and daughters riding together. They have fun.
They have fun.
The sheriff is a female. The head counsel. All of them. It's a female-based sort of community. And since we're celebrating 100 years of women's, you know, right to vote, it's so apropos to have them there. So, and they did point out, we love our men. is what they said. But the women are taking front and center on January 1st.
Cool. Mark, Leeza, thank you so much.
Sure.
Don't forget, you can get prepped and get all ready for the Rose Parade this year as Rose Parade Uncovered, airing Saturdays 7 p.m. right here in KTLA. Don't miss, of course, the 131st Rose Parade presented by Honda on New Year's Day right here on KTLA. Our coverage begins 6 a.m. The parade, 8 a.m.
See you then.
Yeah. We'll join you at 6. We'll be looking forward to seeing you there.
And we'll have more gifts.
Oh, of course.
Snacks.
Swag forthcoming.
Turtlenecks.
Thank you, guys.
You bet. You bet.